Hey there everyone, let's look at this example. It's an application on reflection and refraction of light using Snell's law for the refraction. So it seems that there is a ray coming from this medium, and this medium has a refractive index of 1.1. It impinges on another medium of a refractive index 1.6. Since these are two different, I'm going to call this 1, I'm going to call this 2. After that, the light leaves and goes back to the original refractive index. I'm going to call this n equals 1, and it's equal to 1.1. So it seems that this is light coming, maybe, let's assume this is air, but this is not. That light is coming in air, going through a glass, then impinges inside the house into air again. So that's how things are. If this angle is given to be equal to 35 degrees, we need to find this angle, and some of the light we are going to assume it's going to reflect, and that happens too. We're going to find this angle, and we need to find this angle. And some of the light also gets reflected here. As soon as it hits the glass or whatever that medium is. So we need to find this angle, okay? So let me call this all of these angles. So I'm going to call this angle theta 1. I'm going to call this theta 2. This is theta 3, and this is theta 4, and this is finally as theta 5. Okay, how do we go about doing this problem? Well, this is reflection of light of a straight surface. So you should know that theta 1 should equal to 35 degrees. So that's the first one. That was easy. Now let's find theta 2. To find theta 2, we need to employ Snell's law, which says that N1 sine theta 1 is equal to N2 sine theta 2. N1 is 1.1. times sine the incident angle, which is 35 degrees, is equal to N2, which is 1.6 times sine theta 2. All right, now solving for theta 2, after some calculations you can get theta 2 is equal to 23.2 degrees. If this is 23, this one is 23.2 degrees, this should be 23.2 degrees, because this is parallel light or parallel line, and these two opposite in direction, so theta 2 must equal to theta 3, so theta 3 must be equal to 23.2. Theta 4 is reflection. Reflection is equal to the incident, so this is also 23.2. Now we need to find this angle. Look, you can find it in two ways. Using Snell's law, the same here, assuming that this is N1, this is N2, you can solve for it, and you can find the angle, or you can just pay attention here. It's coming from N1 and it's going out to N1. So this angle must be equal to this angle. So theta 5 must be equal to 35 degrees. And just to make sure, please go ahead and use Snell's law to do that and see if you actually are going to get 35 or not. And that's it for now. Thank you.